Hello guys, this is PanzerMeister36, and this is going to be the third and final part of my StuG Ausf build. Basically, what I've done is I've painted it with a 50-50 mix of Tamiya XF55, Dectan, which is basically concrete color, and dark yellow XF60, which first time with Tamiya paints airbrushing with them, and they are really, really nice to airbrush with. I also use this thinner, which are the Tamiya thinner, this thinner here, and it's really, really nice too. It's a lot more powerful. It also smells a lot more powerful, but I need to clean off all my brushes now because it works a lot better than the thinner that I use for when I'm painting with just normal paints with a paintbrush and stuff like that. But still, it is more expensive and stuff like that, but it works a lot better. So I painted like this Africa Core color, and it's really, really awesome. It's better lighting. And you can see the stowage on the back. That's all I've done. I'm going to go over with probably some of this, just like a plane, and do a bit of kind of dusting stuff on the sides and maybe on the top for like sun bleaching effects, but not everywhere, just to make it kind of have a little contrast. And then I'll be doing like the decaling. I might even go over again with a little lightness of this after the decaling. And then I'll do some weathering and chipping and stuff like that. And I'm going to have to do some nice highlighting for these awesome shell strike marks that I've added on, which look really, really good. So yeah, basically that's going to be this video, because finally I got to paint this, because as I explained last video, basically my garage was full of flies, but now they've all been eviscerated because they all died of starvation or something like that. Yeah, so I'm happy now. Also, up here, I've got kind of a little diorama working on. Not sure if you can really see, because I've got a big bottle of Tamiya cement there holding up a guy. But basically, it's one of these model scene grass mats that I got. I'm going to add some bushes and more stuff to it, but it looks really, really nice. And I've got my Tamiya Panzer II. That was F/G, I think. The first kit I ever built, first tank kit I ever built, and I think it looks really, really good. It's probably either the best or like maybe the second best I've ever done. The only thing I haven't done is added like mud stuff to it, but I'm gonna do some work with some MIG pigments on that. I'm gonna have to buy to make it a nice Russian color, but other than that, I'm gonna keep it the way it is. And I've also got, hold on. There you go, you see behind there, there's some figures. There's a guy there, another guy there. Those were part of this kit, which I got a while ago. German Fighting League in the East. Really, really nice figures. And came with just four in that kit, and I painted the three of them so far. With I used these two colors for the guy here with his fancy camo vest or whatever. And then some other colors like that. I added a little bit of gray and white to kind of lighten and darken it for shadows to fit that. But that is for that guy's shirt and the green polka dots on that guy's vest. And then I used this Model Master enamel stuff. It's basically Russian green for the dark green polka dots on that. And then I used this mixed with some green, normal green, I don't know where it is, to make the German soldiers' suits, and yeah, and also added, like, I just did a little bit of work with like black and other colors, and for the helmets, that was kind of like my own custom Panzer gray stuff. Yeah, the figures look a little green, but actually you can't even really see them, can you? Let's zoom in a little bit. There they are, and there's another guy over there. He's a German Eastern Front tank hunters. He's got a Panzerfaust. And there's going to be another guy there talking to him, kind of working with him there. Those are my guys there. But they look really, really nice. The face. I used my beige tri-art stuff as a base. I'm going to go over this. This stuff here, which I usually use in my airbrush. Basically, I go over the face with that. Which is kind of, it's a little bit gray, honestly, but I don't know. It looks okay if after you go over it with some of this model color, dark flesh, which you have to shake up a lot before you paint with it. Remember that. And then I kind of go back over and do some highlights with this beige stuff again, unbleached titanium. And that gives a nice face. And then for the eyes, just white with black pupil or whatever. That just, you need a really small brush. I've got a 5 below 0 for that, which is pretty small. Yeah. And the boots I did that with a dark gray, and then I went over with a black wash, and that's basically how I do them. I don't wash the entire figure, I just washed their boots and their guns, which are a gray color also. I'm probably going to have a video sometime soon when I paint either that guy or some other person there. Like how to paint a figure, because there's not very many videos about that on YouTube. People are always like, oh, it's hard to do, hard to film it. Well, I'll try my best. But my diorama, you can see it's a little bit bigger than this scene here. They're looking at the map, or what's a map right now. Soon will be a map on the back of this Panzer II. And I kind of want to have like a Panzer III or some other vehicle, maybe a little bit smaller than that, like a Sidkiff's like 222 or a Puma or 223, something there. Just I may have a guy sitting on that tank kind of conversing with these three guys over here. And I kind of planned this out a little bit. I got the two guys here looking at the map. That guy's kind of facing them, but he's looking in this direction. And this guy here with his Panzerfaust, and there's going to be some person who I'm going to use from the Cyberhobby. Well, actually this kit here, because it came with some people. I'm going to have him there, because he's kind of in a pose where he's kind of standing and kind of like pointing with his hand like that, you know. And I guess if I just put him beside that guy, kind of talking to him and pointing like this is how the Panzerfaust works, it'll look pretty good. Yeah, that's basically it, but I'm going to have some videos on this of me probably constructing the Panzer III or whatever I buy. And me probably painting one of the figures, and then maybe just a sum up and, I don't know, a little more scenery, because it looks good right now, but I need some trees and more bushes and stuff like that. Like maybe some of this, which is like woodland scenics, olive stuff. Olive green. I don't know, it's like tree branch material. Fine leaf. No. I don't know. I think it's fine leaf material, I'm pretty sure. But yeah, these grass mats are really, really good. So I've done a little bit of work painting the wheels black. And painting the tools along here with various shades of gray. I use basically have a light gray, dark gray, and a bluey gray. And I usually just kind of go over with the light gray first or the bluey gray, and then I'll kind of do some dry brushing and chipping stuff with the dark gray, or maybe the bluey gray if I use the light gray underneath. And if I use different colors, it kind of makes a bit of a contrast. And makes it kind of stand out. Because if I have, because this one here, you can see it's very bright, because I use the white stuff. And I dry brushed it with the light gray stuff, and I dry brushed it with the bluey gray stuff. This one I painted with the dark gray stuff, and then I dry brushed it with the light gray stuff, because it had lots of raised details. So that's a bit of a difference in that stuff there, is with the bluey gray dry brushed with light gray. And this here, I dry brushed it with all three. This, I think it's a jacker or something that lifts part of the tank up. Just to keep it kind of this color it was before with the tank, not being painted gray like all these other things are. So next I'm going to paint the wheels on the side of the tank. And the stowage, and probably the tracks. Also for these shell marks on the front here. What I've done is I've painted them with the dark gray, then I've dry brushed, which is basically a Panzer gray color really, and then I dry brushed them with the light gray. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over with some dark, I do believe it's graphite gray color, which is basically halfway between like the Panzer gray and black. It's going to be like the really deep parts of the shell mark. I'll kind of use it like a wash, but I won't actually thin it down very much, and I'll paint it on to keep more control and stuff like that. But they do look very nice when I've highlighted them like this, so I'm going to have to do that graphite stuff soon. But overall, it's looking really nice. I decided to put all the paint these details on it before I went over with the XF55 deck tan, because I was going to go over that and make it like a light tint kind of on the sides of the wheels here, because there's going to be sand there and also along the top. But then I decided that I should do that after to kind of blend all the details in. Like, all like the black on the wheels and the stuff on the back too, and all the tools, they would be tinted and covered by the sand as well as the tank. One thing that I'm not gonna put on when I tint it would be the periscope and this piece here, which is the commander's hatch. You can see I've put a piece of tape there to cover it. Basically, I painted the back end of it. Well, this is the top end because it sits kind of like that in the tank. With the XF60, which is a little darker, but it doesn't matter because it's gonna be upside down. And then the side with a primer red color, so it's gonna kind of sit there, something like that. But it will be usually closed, so I guess I should not tint that. And also the periscope is not gonna be tinted under there too. So I'm gonna finish off painting these tools and wheels and track and stuff like that, and the stowage on the rear. So now I'm using this dark graphite gray color, which is almost black but still a little gray, to add the dark spots in these shell strakes. I've gone over with a panzer gray color, which kind of be where the paint was kind of chipped and it kind of peeled back a little bit or something like that. And then I highlighted that with lighter gray colors. And I'm going to go over it with this graphite gray color in the darker parts farther down. Kind of had like almost shadows, but also at the same time a little bit of dry brushing over the whole thing. It should look pretty good. I'm not really trying to be perfect here, I'm just kind of basically dry brushing and kind of washing at the same time. It's getting into the deeper details farther down, but also kind of dry brushing the higher details up with a kind of metallic dark gray color. Can't exactly see it on the camera, but you can definitely see it where I am in real life. Maybe if I zoom in. Oh, not that far. I'm not sure if you can really see it, but it looks darker. That looks pretty good. It really brings out these these shell strikes that I added, which I think they look really good. I've seen some people do that, just like hack at it with knives or sanding sticks, something like that. But this way, actually, if you use the soldering gun like I did, I guess it's more risky because you could just burn right through the tank. But I don't know. You just kind of have to kind of do a couple of light passes because it will kind of go down a bit when you. Because when you come by, it kind of pushes part of it down and the sides up of this mark you're making, which looks really realistic. But if you go all at once, you're just going to go right through, and then you've made a whole new tank. But yeah, it makes a really nice effect. And I do recommend it, but I recommend you practice first, which I didn't do. I just took it all over the place. I don't know, I just kind of thought it would work, and it did. I'm not really one for practicing before I try something. Oops. Alrighty, so for the wheels, I'm just using black. That's my black carbon black stuff. Just straight out of the jar. Because it's kind of nice and thick, but not super thin. And basically, I'm just painting it on how you would. Usually, I would use a brighter, kind of like a panzer grayish color for the wheels because they kind of fade and they don't look super black. But since I'm going to go over it with a beige color for tinting and sand effects, I figured that I might as well just paint it black because it's going to be tinted then. This isn't really a complicated procedure, it's just painting carefully. Try not to get any inside the wheel. Just get another brush here, bigger one. This is something like 00. So it's a little bit bigger, but still it's quite small. And there's paint all over it, so now it's all over my hands. When I first was thinking about painting this tank, I was thinking that I should probably put an undercoat of the panzer gray color and then do that salt technique, where you pour salt onto it and then somehow make it stick with hairspray or something, and then you paint it over with the panzer sand color, whatever, sand gelb. And then when you're done that, you can kind of work off the salt with a paintbrush or something like that. And then you get kind of chipping marks. And I was thinking about doing that, but then I decided not to because I thought that would kind of stand out and look kind of ugly on a tank that's kind of a yellow color. So I'm hopefully going to do that on another tank, one that's more green or something like that, and that'll look better on. But for this one, I'm just going to do some chipping with a paintbrush or something like along the edges. Just the normal, simple stuff. Now I'm going to put on the decals. Basically, they're just mixed decals. I've got like an Africa core thing on the front there from the Panzer II over there. And these German crosses, I think, are from my SU-76 kit. SU-85 Dragon kit. But I've seen the same thing on German tanks, a very large cross. So I use them, and I've also got some number 2s from, I'm pretty sure it's the Befelsjäger, basically a Martyr 3 Ausf by Dragon, which is also a really, really good kit. And basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my microsol, which is decal softening stuff, and I'm going to put it on the area where this decal's gonna go, which is in the middle of this panel there. Just right in there. Let me go and wait for that to kind of soak in. I've got my decal over here. I think that looks straight. And then now I'm going to put more Microsol on that. And I was just soaking the decal in a bowl of warm water. And now I've added some kind of heavy streaking to these decals that I added with to make a thinner. And then I also added a lot of chipping all over the tank where people would walk. So kind of up here, along here, kind of back down there, over here, across over here, back down there. And I'm going to have to paint the tracks, stuff like that. When I go over with the my tint later with this deck tan or whatever, those will be toned down. Yeah, so gonna have to finish off painting the wheels on this side, the stowage, and the tracks, which I think I'm just gonna do Panzer Gray because they're gonna be covered with the tinting pretty well. Now I'm painting the stowage with various browns and kind of yellowy beigey colors, like these I don't even know what these are. They're like look like bags or tarps rolled up. I just painted them with desert yellow. The machine gun ammunition there, I just dry brushed that with a bunch of grays and black colors. Tracks are all Panzer Gray. I'm gonna do some highlighting and some kind of rust work on those soon. This box here, I painted it with the Ausf 60 here for a little bit of contrast. And this kind of bag back there was just this Panzer blue-gray color along with some light gray highlighting. And the binoculars here were black, and I'll dry brush them a bit. And this here, this container for the gas mask, I'm pretty sure is that what it is. That was gone with my blue Panzer Gray color, and then dry brushed with the light gray. And basically I'm just kind of looking at some of the pictures of figures that I have, because these are all parts from from the Panzer 2 kit. These are the pieces for the figures, all their gear and stuff like that. I'm just looking at the box and kind of figuring out what colors they should be. Not exactly super picky about realism and stuff. Yeah, so I'm gonna have to paint this little thing right there. Looks like some kind of holder for MP40 ammunition or something. So I'm just gonna paint that with some brown. Burnt umber, lightened a bit because I'm out of the brown that I'm looking for. I'm going to lighten it with the titanium white color, which is a light beige, just because I feel like it. Because I've already done a bunch of the other things highlighted with the white, and I want a bit of contrast. Usually if I'm painting like the wood parts on tools and stuff like that, I'll just basically mix up brown and white, or brown and gray, or brown and beige in this case, and just kind of make up a color or a couple of colors for wood, because wood's usually not exactly a solid color. And now I've got a brown-ish color here. I actually painted a little bit of brown onto that bag, so I'm going over with some gray again on that. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take some black and paint the rest of that MP40 clip pouch, or whatever it is, magazine pouch. And I'm going to go over with some Panzer Gray and light gray colors for dry brushing highlights and stuff. Dry brushing with a bit of Panzer Gray there, which is a little bit brighter, and then I'm going to do a little bit of this light gray color. You can see it there. It's basically like a concrete-y color. It's my own custom mix. And now here's the finished stowage. And basically I went over and did a little more work on the brown and stuff like that of the things that are made of like leather or other materials like that. Painted the ropes here, the tie-down ropes. Those are also brown, a little bit beige or brown. And the tracks, I painted them. You can see the three colors behind it. I've got like basically Panzer Gray there, and an earlier kind of bluey Panzer Gray color in the middle, and then a really light gray there. I've been using these colors for most of the work here. Basically, I just painted the tracks with Panzer Gray, then went over with a fairly thick dry brushing of the bluey stuff, so that basically almost all of it, except for the lower down parts, were covered. And then I did a very selective dry brushing with the lighter color. And it looks pretty good. And now here's my kit. After I gave it a quick tint with the XF55, and it looks really, really nice. I kind of masked off the sides here and did a lot more of the tint on the lower tracks, stuff like that, because there's more sand and stuff down there. And then I went over the top of the bit lighter tone of it, and it really kind of blended in all the chipping effects. And then I went over and added a little bit more chipping on top of the faded chipping in the heavier parts. Yeah, it looks really, really nice. The decals, they look superb. I'm not sure if you can really see them because they're faded so much, but you can just barely see like the heavily scratched two in the cross on that side. Two in the cross on that side. And then the AfriCorps thingy on the front. And the chipping effects, they look really, like the shell mark effects look really, really nice. I think I might kind of go over a few of them to make them look more modern, recent. Because they also got the tint, but I know they look pretty, really nice. Yeah, I like the how it has the option of having like the hatch there open, also the commander's hatch over here open, but I didn't do that because the commander figure didn't look really nice. But I had the not gonna have the hatch open and the periscope out. You can kind of see inside, but I painted it black, so it's okay. Stowage on the back looks really nice after I've gone over with the tint. Really nice stuff from the Tamiya kit. Yeah, I did. We can't see that. I went over these exhaust things with a red oxide color, and then I went over them with the tint, so you can just see they look a little bit of red underneath. Looks fine. The tracks. I went over them with the Panzer Gray after I finished talking to you guys and painted the wheels on this side, and then they got the tint, so now they look nice and sandy. And the gun on the front like that looks really, really nice. It's hollow and everything. Overall, this kit was really nice. I did a review of it in the last video. Basically, I said it was like about a 7.5, 8 out of 10. Really nice. It's a bit of an older kit, but still good. You can go over and maybe add some more detail, like I did these shell marks, because, and also add your own photo etch, stuff like that, because there's not very much stuff. Like, there's no stowage or anything else to put on it. And the decals, it's actually 3 decal schemes, but they're all exactly the same, just with different numbers on it. So, I don't know. I think an Africord decal scheme would have been good for this kit, but I guess I could just make it myself. Yeah, they're really a fantastic kit. I recommend it to really anybody, just more for the beginner and intermediate level, because it's not really like a super detailed hardcore kit for like all the experienced super awesome modelers to work on. It's more just like a little simple do your own time nice easy kit, but still it had a bunch of pieces, and it didn't have like, you know, like 70 pieces like some of the really beginner kits do, and it has a lot of detail and stuff like that too. So yeah, basically, awesome kit.
Turns out really fantastic in the end if you
like do the weathering and stuff really well. And
yeah, so gonna have some kind of video slideshow here, or some close-up shots of my kit. So this is Panzermeister 36. Thanks for watching, and goodbye.